back it up. There's a lot of rummage sales this weekend. And it was kind of rainy both Saturday and Sunday. So potentially a lot of sales got rained out. Well, they still have a lot of stuff left over. Well, where do you think that stuff goes? You think they save it for next rummage sale for next weekend? Yeah, some of them maybe, but most of that stuff ends up being donated to the thrift shops. So we're gonna stop at some thrift shops throughout this week and see if that's the case for most of these shops. Generally it is. So right now most of the good stuff sitting in a thrift store, and hopefully they price it, you know, where we can flip it and make a little money. So let's get it down the road.
Our sophistication makes you wanna quit the bitch you dating. Let's skip the games, let's quit the playing.
Nothing special here, guys. Just a nice, comfortable gel-like and spring bike seat. Because sometimes I sell a bike and they're like, well, they like the bike, but the seat's not that comfortable. Well, I'll give them a seat with their bike purchase. And anything to seal the deal. It's what I can do. I paid $4 for it. Little things always add up, okay? And that's one of my many tips to get it down the road. I don't need the money, but I got some stale product that are sporting goods, and when it builds up, I just come bring it all to play it again. They buy it all off me. I generally make a few dollars and definitely my money back, because I'm usually picking up nice sporting good items. But if you need to drop it off and you're not selling on eBay or Facebook, come to play it again, sell it all to them. You know, I sold them two official NFL footballs, Wilson's, and that catcher's mitt, and they gave me $12. I probably didn't have any more than $3-4 in all of it. So I have two softball bats that are actually pretty nice, and I did get offers on them already on eBay, so I'm just kind of hanging on to them, but they'd be glad to take those off my hands right now, because softball bats are pretty pricey and hard to get a hold of one that you want as well. So maybe I have a bat that somebody needs. So, but anyway, yeah, play it against sports. Unload the death piles there that don't sell. And that's another tip, get it down the road. One is a Denon, like a 6.1. It's got zone 2. That's 460 watts. Okay, this is a very nice, HDMI is a very nice receiver. I will not let this go out of my house for anything less than $100. Pay $30 for it today. And the other electronic is a Pioneer CD recorder. And when I looked this recorder up on eBay, I was blessed, because there was multiple sales of $80 or more. So I will go ahead and put that up there for $79.95 plus shipping. I paid $20 for this. So we're gonna go ahead and hopefully net about $50 off the one and about $70 off the other. Maybe I can get a little more than $100. Guys don't like to pay a lot for these receivers, but they're gonna know it's nice, and if they want it, they will pay up, because it does work. I demoed both of these units in-house already. They're ready to go. I just gotta clean them up, take a nice shot of them, put them on Facebook, and maybe the one on eBay, and get it down the road. Pack it up, pack it in, let me begin. We got two big speakers, but we're already packed in here. Two bikes back here and two back there. How am I gonna fit those two speakers in here? Wow, no problem. Let me show you. Well, here we go again, guys. I got some 15-inch Optimuses. $10 a piece. I'll be asking about $100 for this set. I've sold towers before. They don't last long. The only problem is now I gotta drive all this stuff home. I got four bikes in here. And two tower speakers. Okay? A lot of you guys wouldn't even attempt that, let alone now sell it all. So, that's what we do on this channel. Let's get it down the road. He's going the distance! He's going for speed! fix up these boats. This one is from Chicago. That's a Chicago original Schwinn chromoly frame. It's not in the best shape. This mongoose is a BMX. So, you know, maybe 50 bucks for that. We'll see. Got these four bikes from my junk associate for 40 bucks. Plus I got a Cannondale that needs pretty much only good for the frame. It's gonna need new gears and stuff. But. Ching Ching Chat here, it's Wednesday. And I bought this bike helmet for 10 bucks at a rummage sale. And I just sold it on eBay for 50 bucks. There it is, it's Specialized. Very aerodynamic and everything. It has a lot of information on the inside. The pads are real good. So it sold for 50 bucks, pretty much within 24 hours. So yeah, nice bike helmets. Look them up.
Well, Trex,
from one of my associates hooked me up with these three bikes for 50 bucks, and they all need a little bit of work, but they all should go for around $60 to $80 a piece. So we'll see what we can do and see if we can get it down the road. $20 each. I want these to land anywhere from $100 to $200 for the pair. I would have had four of these speakers if I would have came here before my dentist appointment, but you know how it goes. There was another reseller here and he said, you know what, I'll give you a pair of them. I came back to look at them. They're still there. No one took the tags, but at least I got two. But if I would have showed up earlier, I would have had two pairs of these for $80. I would have got $150 a pair for them. So, it's all right. We'll get them next time. We'll get these home and get them on the interwebs and get it down the road. Thing was, I was just at that Goodwill just a couple days ago, maybe Monday, and maybe Sunday night. But yeah, I mean, it pays to almost be checking every day at your thrift stores because you never know what's gonna be sitting there. I walked in there was four of those speakers there. You never know what's gonna be here. I made a lot of money off that Goodwill. A lot of people know about that Goodwill. It's very good. So, anyway. So I don't do clothing very often, and when I do, I get something very nice. Nike, Tri-Fit. It's got 3M hits. This is a running shirt. Long sleeve, got the holes for the thumbs, and it's a collared half zip, and I got it for $4.99 half off. I got this for $2.50, and I will sell it for $24.95 plus shipping, and that's a $20 bill, basically. Let's get it down the road. Another bike helmet, guys, for $2. It's a adult size, 54 to 62, adult medium, adult large. But I should get about, it's got a little damage right there, but the rest of it is pretty clean. So I'm gonna ask about, I don't know, maybe $30 for this one. Maybe 35, maybe 39. That last one surprised me. I never sold a bike helmet before, but I'm starting to look at some of these bike helmets and notice some are more fancier than the others. A little better quality than the others. So I took a chance and I bought one at that rummage sale for $5. Well, I put it up for $49.95 and it sold. I just showed you that earlier. Well, now I go into this thrift store and I haven't found anything at this thrift store in a long time. I find some things here and there, but nothing worth talking about. But here's another bike helmet. There was probably about 10 there, probably a Bell, and that there was also a Bontrager. But Bontrager, Trek, Specialized, Cannondale helmets like that catch my eye because they have more airflow design, and they're just of a little bit better quality than your average ones. I mean, you can see the detail, the plastic that would go around the neck, stuff like that. So I'll shoot for the moon on that. You know, I'll probably put it up there for $39.95, something like that. Hopefully it'll surprise me. Maybe I'll get it down. But just saying, you know, you gotta take a chance on new things, you know. Just because you don't see a sales history, if you know the product is of higher quality, and there isn't a huge competition market for it, chances are you can sell it for maybe a pretty decent price, and you might surprise yourself, so. Just a jackhammer bat, guys. Louisville. Official softball, 32 inch, 27 ounces. This is basically a woman's softball bat, and $5, and I'm gonna put it up there for 25. I've been having a little rough luck with softball bats, but either way, I can go sell them to play it again if they don't pan out. What I'm really looking for is those really expensive softball bats. You know what I'm talking about. They're $100 to $200. They're basically, they're fat for fast pitch and yada, 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 and they have more specs, yada, 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 but I'm always looking for bats. So I find some that are worth, you know, a little bit of money, so see if we can get it down the road. So I'm getting lucky today with the half off or something. That one was half off. It started at 20, but half off of that, so it made it 10. I think that bike just needs a little bit of air in the tires. Looks like nobody even drove it. There's still the spiky knobs on the tires. I think someone rode this bike literally one or two times and it sat. It did take a little rust, but it's a 21 speed, which is pretty high. And I think this bike could easily reach $60. So yeah, I'm gonna get it down the road. Guys, I just sold that Schwinn vintage bike for $2. I was gonna just put it up for sale, check out the value, bring it to a shop, and evaluate if it's worth. And this guy came by and said, I'll give you $200 right now for it. It's one of my associates that works with me, and he said he just had one just like it when he was a kid. That's why he wants to hang it in his garage. So, there you go, guys. It was a made in Chicago Schwinn bike. There was a lot of original parts on it. I got it from my junk man associate with about four bikes that time. You just seen me pick them up. And I gave him $50 for all those bikes. I already got 200. And I already got three other bikes to sell. So, bikes make money. Bikes make me, well, close to $700 this month bikes are gonna make me. Bikes make money. And guess I got that one down the road, huh? Got that from a new acquaintance of mine that said he had this and he wanted to sell it to me for $50 because he knew what I was driving and knew what I was about. So this is basically your ultimate sleeper. I know guys are into sleepers. I always kind of wanted a sleeper, and well, this one fits the bill. This one fits the bill to a T. So that's a guarantee. That's a big 10-4. See you next week.